Backyard Brains presents a new experiment, how to stimulate nervous and muscle system tissue easily. The equipment you will need is a cockroach with which you will take a leg for your experiment, a signal generator such as an iPhone with which to deliver stimuli to your cockroach leg, a Y splitter that splits the output of your signal generator to an external speaker to hear your stimuli, and a cable that terminates in alligator clips that attach to needles you implant in the cockroach leg for your experiment. Since the music that comes out of an iPhone or any kind of music player is nothing more than electrical waveforms, what if we have the output of the iPhone go directly to the cockroach leg? Whoa. Now notice I also have the iPhone hooked up to an external speaker so you can hear the stimuli being delivered. This demo immediately grabs students' attention and can lead into a discussion of how to excite nervous and muscle system tissue. Let's take a closer look. Now using hip-hop music to excite a cockroach leg is all well and good, but let's try to do some serious observations and measurements on the excitability of the muscle and nervous system tissue within the leg. I've downloaded a signal generation program called FreakGen onto my iPhone, which allows me to play biphasic square pulses of a variety of frequency and amplitudes and deliver such to the leg. Now, there are many free signal generating programs out there on the internet that will work on your computer or phone. Just Google it. So you can see at about 2000 Hz, I'm playing with the amplitude or volume, and it has varying degrees of effects on the excitability of the leg. Now if I drop the frequency down to 20 Hz, I see with very, very small volume, I can get contraction of the leg. I can start systematically mapping the best frequencies and lowest amplitudes required to excite the leg, and I'm doing the sort of experiments graduate students typically do and get papers published on. But here I'm doing it in my basement on my tabletop with a minimum of equipment. You can do it too.
Oscillating at 20 Hz.
Now you can see in the Backyard Brains lab book, I've mapped out which volumes and frequencies cause excitation of the cockroach leg. And you can see at the high frequencies, we get no movement, regardless of the volume, whereas at 20 Hz, we get very nice movement across all amplitudes. Now you're probably thinking, what does this mapping of amplitude and frequency in a cockroach leg have to do with anything? Well, microstimulation techniques of this kind are actually used in human patients for Parkinson's disease and deep brain stimulation and functional electrical stimulation whereby muscles of paralyzed patients are excited with electricity. Now you may notice over time throughout your experiments that the leg's responsiveness to electrical excitation decreases over time. This could be due to the leg dying or habituation, both interesting hypotheses. So I often throughout my experiments will check to see if I still get evoked discharge of spikes from the leg. You can see I'm removing the excitation cables, turning the spiker box on.
The leg is still alive.
You can also try this microstimulation experiment on a variety of other organisms, including grasshoppers, which are quite nice because they have very large muscles in their hind jumping legs. Please do let us know what you come up with. Happy neuroscience and happy discoveries.